Welcome to this painting video where we're going to show you how to paint the black matted fur and the exposed flesh on your packs of Soulblight Gravelords Direwolves. Now, to prepare our model for painting here, we've already sprayed it Chaos Black. That's the perfect colour to use on a black direwolf. The first thing we'll be doing is painting the fur, and here we're going to start with a dry brush of Eshin Grey. Once we've done that, we'll then dry brush it with Storm Vermin Fur, and then finally Administratum Grey. First of all, it's that Eshin Grey, and here I've got my medium dry brush. Let's take some Eshin Grey here from the pot. I've got a bit of tissue paper prepared here, and I'm just going to be taking it now onto the tissue paper and brushing off almost all of the paint here, just getting those nice circular motions, working it into the tissue paper to get rid of almost all the paint until there's just a little bit left on the brush. Then onto the direwolf. Here, I'm going to be using a dry brush motion all over the entire model here to pick out the fur like this. You can see very subtly that the edges are being picked up by the dry brush. Do this nice and lightly so the absolute tips and edges of the detail is picked up. Then over the top of this, it's another dry brush, this time with Storm Vermin Fur, which will add some subtle brown tones into our wolf's fur. Then finally, a dry brush of Administratum Grey. And here we're going to be adding a little bit more and pressing a little bit heavier on the fur areas. So around the mane here, the tail and the underbelly as well. There we go, that's the dry brush done. But you can see on some areas of the wolf, for example, the hindquarters there, that the dry brush has picked up some areas we may not want it to. So what we're going to do now is go back in with some black Templar contrast paint and kind of use it like a layer paint on the larger, flatter areas of the wolf, just help blacken down that fur again. For this, grab your medium layer brush. Let's take some black Templar here from the pot and onto our palette. Now here we want it to be a nice thin coat, so just going to get a little bit on the brush, just like this, and then onto the wolf. Here we're just picking out those larger, flatter areas, for example, here on the hindquarters that we want to be fully black, just making sure we're leaving the absolute tips the dry brush colour we'd done before. There we go, that's the black Templar applied, and you can see the difference it makes on the large, flat surfaces of the wolf. Okay, up next, let's paint the exposed flesh on our direwolf. And for this, we're going to start off with a base coat of Wazdaka Red. Once that's dry, we'll then apply a layer of Squig Orange over the top before applying Blood for the Blood God all over to make it look super gory. First of all, it's that base coat of Wazdaka Red. Here, grab your small airbrush. Let's take a small amount of paint here from the pot and apply it to our palette. Now here, I'm going to take some water to help thin it down to make sure it falls into those deep areas. Then onto our direwolf. Here we're picking out all those areas of exposed flesh on the model, so you can see a bit of skin poking through the fur here, for example. I'm going to paint that in. All these little bits of flesh showing through the fur. I'm going to paint those in very carefully here, and do your best not to hit the fur around it as you've already painted that. Next up, I've got some Squig Orange, and here I'm applying it as a layer over the top, just leaving some of the lower parts of the muscles exposed as the Wazdaka Red. Then with that done, we've got some Blood for the Blood God technical paint and a small layer brush here. Just going to paint it into all of these little bits of recesses here and the gaps in the flesh to make it look like it's disgusting, gory flesh. Here, if you decide to go a bit over and hit the edges of the fur as well, it'll make it look like that fur has been covered in blood where the flesh has been exposed. There we go, with the Blood for the Blood God applied onto that exposed flesh, it's looking disgusting and gory. And that's how you can paint the black fur and exposed flesh on your packs of direwolves. I hope you enjoyed this video. Happy painting.